Good morning to my brothers and sisters in Christ. God bless you this morning. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we come now to give you all the honor, glory, and praise. Father, I pray for those that are viewing this message this morning. Father, I thank you for blessing me and using me and allowing me to teach your word this morning. Father, continue to look after the sick and the shut in. Father, continue to take care of those who have lost loved ones. Father, be with those first responders. Father, bless our leaders around the country, in our communities, in our state. Father, let them lean toward you when they're making decisions. That way that will cut down on all the confusion. And Father, go into the prison and be with those that are seeking your face, listening for your voice. Help those that are locked in and let them know that they are not locked out. And Father, last but not surely least, I just want to say thank you, thank you, thank you for Jesus Christ, my Lord and Savior, who came and died on that old rugged cross to save a wretch like me. So, Father, you've heard my plea and you've heard my petition. And if you do all these things for me in the name of Jesus, which I am praying, I'll be so very, very careful to give you all the glory, all the honor, and all the praise. And it's in Jesus' name I pray these things, Father. Amen. Good morning, all you church school scholars out there and teachers and all the brothers and sisters out there that are listening in. Our church school lesson today is for May the 2nd, 2021. Man, time is flying. And our devotional reading for this lesson today will be coming from the book of Acts, chapter 4, verses 18 through 21. And our background passage will be coming from 1 Kings, chapter 22, verses 1 through 40. Now, our printed text is going to get chopped up a little bit. These are the scriptures we're going to be using for the lesson. Amen. Our printed text will be coming from 1 Kings, chapter 22, verses 15 through 23. And then it goes down to verses 26 through 28. Now, the title of our lesson today, in your Sunday school books, it'll probably say, Speaking Truth Boldly. And if you have a commentary, it'll say, Micaiah, Speaking Truth to Power. Now, our memory verse for this lesson, this is the way it goes. And Micaiah said, As the Lord liveth, what the Lord said unto me, that will I speak. And that's coming from 1 Kings chapter 22, verses 14. And for all those out there, I will be using the King James Version for these scriptures today. And then after that, I will give a little introduction or a background. And then we'll do our lesson review. Amen. So let us go ahead and read our printed text this morning. 1 Kings chapter 22, verses 15 to 23. And then we're going to move over to verses 26 through 28. So he came to the king. And the king said unto him, Micaiah, shall we go against Ramoth Gilead to battle, or shall we forbear? And he answered him, Go and prosper, for the Lord shall deliver it unto the hand of the king. And the king said unto him, How many times shall I adjure thee that thou tell me nothing but that which is true in the name of the Lord? And he said, I saw all Israel scattered upon the hills, as sheep that have not a shepherd. And the Lord said, These have no master. Let them return every man to his house in peace. And the king of Israel said unto Jehoshaphat, Did I not tell thee that he would prophesy no good concerning me, but evil? And he said, Hear thou therefore the word of the Lord. I saw the Lord sitting on his throne, and all the host of heaven standing by him on his right hand and on his left. And the Lord said, Who shall persuade Ahab that he may go up and fall at Ramoth Gilead? And one said on this manner, and another said on that manner. And there came forth the Spirit and stood before the Lord and said, I will persuade him. And the Lord said unto him, Wherewith? And he said, I will go forth, and I will be a lying spirit in the mouth of all his prophets. And he said, Thou shalt persuade him and prevail also. Go forth and do so. Now therefore, behold, the Lord hath put a lying spirit in the mouth of all these thy prophets, and the Lord has spoken evil concerning thee. Now we're going to move down to verses 26 through 28. And the king of Israel said, take Micaiah and carry him back unto Ammon, the governor of the city, and to Joash, the king's son, and say, thus said the king, put this fellow in the prison and feed him with bread of affliction and with water of affliction until I come in peace. And Micaiah said, if thou return at all in peace, the Lord had not spoken by me. And he said, hearken, O people, every one of you, God's word for God's people. Now, let me get into a little introduction so y'all know what's going on here. But let me say this right off the top of my head. To speak boldly for the Lord is not popular. Because there's a lot of people out there like doing what they're doing and they don't want to change. And they don't want to hear God's truth. Some of these people might try to hurt your feelings. Some of these people might even try to do you bodily harm. And sometimes standing up for the Lord might cause you to go to prison. But you got to remain steadfast. You have to be bold. Stand on God's word. You must fear God more than you fear man. And God will reward you in the end. And that's what's going on in today's lesson. This prophet, Micaiah, stood up to this mighty king, and he was an evil king. So let's go ahead and get into the introduction. Ahab was one of the evilest rulers over the children of Israel because of his worshiping of idols, and he was greedy too. I'm able to throw that in there. He was a very greedy king and did not care who he hurt to get the things that he wanted. The bad thing about all of this, he knew that God had forbidden idol worshiping, but he went on and did it anyway. And it did not help matters that he married Jezebel, who encouraged him to do all sorts of evil. Now, he already had 400 of his own prophets lying to him and everything, but she brought 450 more who worshiped the idol Baal, just making things worse on the children of Israel. He surrounded himself with 400 heathen prophets who only told him what he wanted to hear. There it is. They lied and said that their prophecy came from the Lord. Yeah, they lied. They didn't want to make him mad. They was more afraid of him than they was God. The prophet Elijah, now this is one of God's prophets. The prophet Elijah told him all of what God was going to do to him and his entire family due to his disobedience to the Lord. Ahab became so afraid of the prophet that he tore his clothes, put on rags, fasted, and he slept in sackcloth and went about in deep humility. And because of his humbleness, God told Elijah, I will not do this thing that I am going to do to him during his lifetime, but I will take out my wrath on his sons and his descendants. Now, after 3 years, Watch what happens to this man. Now, it has been 3 years, and there had been no war between Syria and Israel. But during that third year, King Jehoshaphat came to visit King Ahab. During his visit, a conversation ensued. Ahab discussed the possibility of starting a war against Syria. Do you realize that the Syrians are occupying Ramah Gilead, and we're sitting here and not doing a thing about it? What if we was to join our armies together? We can go in and regain control of that city. And Jehoshaphat replied, of course, man. You and I, we brothers. My army is at your command. Then Jehoshaphat, now watch this, smart man. Then Jehoshaphat said, shouldn't we consult with the Lord first and see what he wants us to do? So King Ahab summoned, look at this, his 400 heathen prophets and asked them, shall I attack Ramoth Gilead or not? And they all said, yeah, go ahead, for God will help you conquer it. But Jehoshaphat, wise guy, man is smart, he then asked Ahab, isn't there any prophet of the Lord here? In other words, don't you have anybody beside these yes men that are really in a relationship who really has God's ear and God has their ear? He said, I would like to ask him too. Well, there's one, the king replied, but I hate him, for he never prophesies anything good. He always has something gloomy to say about me. His name is Micaiah, the son of Imlah. So the king summoned for Micaiah. Now look at the messenger. And the messenger told Micaiah that it would be in your best interest, Micaiah, if you would prophesize the same thing as the other 400 heathen prophets had revealed to the king. But look at Micaiah, bold brother. Micaiah replied back and said, this I vow, that I will say only what the Lord tells me to. Now that brings us up to our scripture. Let's go ahead and do 22:15-16. So he came to the king, and the king said unto him, Micaiah, shall we go against Ramoth Gilead to battle, or shall we forbear? And he answered him, go and prosper, for the Lord shall deliver it unto the hand of the king. And the king said unto him, how many times shall I adjure thee that thou tell me nothing but that which is true in the name of the Lord? See, Micaiah was being brought before the king because I guess he wanted to satisfy Jehoshaphat. So he was brought before the king, and the king asked, Micaiah, shall we attack Ramoth Gilead or not? And Micaiah told him, why, of course, go right ahead. Then Micaiah told him, you will have a great victory, for the Lord will cause you to conquer. Of course, in his response, Micaiah was putting doubts in the king's mind. If you should win, the Lord was with you. But if you should lose, the Lord was not with you. The king knew in his mind that Micaiah was being sarcastic in this response because they had clashed before, and Micaiah has never prophesied in his favor. And the king told him, how many times must I tell you to only speak to me what the Lord tells you? Now watch this. He get ready to prophesize now and tell him the truth. And he said, this is verse 22:17-18. I saw all Israel scattered up on the hills, scattered as sheep that have not a shepherd. And the Lord said, these have no master. Let them return every man to his house in peace. And the king of Israel said unto Jehoshaphat, did I not tell thee that he would prophesy no good concerning me but evil? Micaiah's response to the king was not to his liking. And he told the king, I saw all of Israel. They were all scattered up on that mountain as sheep without a shepherd. And the Lord said, their king is dead. Send them to their homes. By this saying, Micaiah was letting the king know that the Lord was not going to give him the victory in this battle. He was warning the other people, don't engage in this war, but to go on back to your homes. But if you persist, your king will surely die and you will be left without a leader. This was not the message that Ahab was looking for. He believed that Micaiah was deliberately sabotaging his plans. Micaiah's stance confirmed the king's suspicion, and he turned to Jehoshaphat and said, didn't I tell you this would happen? You the one wanted to bring him in here. Didn't I tell you he was going to do this? He never tells me anything good. It's always bad. So we're going to go to 22:19-23. Going to read these four or five verses. And I want y'all to see what else is going on in here, because he is still prophesizing. And he said, hear thou therefore the word of the Lord. I saw the Lord sitting on his throne, and all the host of heaven standing by him on his right hand and on his left. And the Lord said, who shall persuade Ahab that he may go up and fall at Ramoth Gilead? And one said on this manner, and another said on that manner. And there came forth a spirit and stood before the Lord and said, I will persuade him. And the Lord said unto him, wherewith? And he said, I will go forth, and I will be a lying spirit in the mouth of all of his prophets. And he said, thou shalt persuade him and prevail also. Go forth and do so. Now, therefore, behold, the Lord had put a lying spirit in the mouth of all these prophets, these thy prophets, and the Lord had spoken evil concerning thee. Micaiah had received another message from the Lord. And he said, listen to this further word from the Lord. Now, I want y'all to know, as we get a little deeper into this paraphrase and interpretation, God has meetings. Yes, he does. And he's explaining to the king, I saw God sitting in a meeting. And this is what's going on in the meeting. Just listen to this. I saw God sitting on his throne, and the armies of heaven stood around him. And then the Lord said, who will entice Ahab to go and die at Ramoth-Gilead? Now, various suggestions were being made. Now, they all said, well, we could do this. Maybe we could do that. Well, why don't we try this? But one angel approached the Lord and said, I'll do it. God said, how? The Lord replied, and he replied, I will go down as a lion spirit in the mouth of all of his prophets. I'm going to get in all 400 of them. I will go down and be a lion spirit in all of their mouths. And the Lord replied, that will do it. You will succeed. Go ahead. And then Micaiah told it, King Ahab, don't you see? Don't you see? The Lord has put a lion spirit in the mouth of all these prophets you got. But the fact of the matter is that the Lord has decreed disaster upon you. You go on and do it. But disaster is coming your way. You see what is going on here, students, brothers and sisters? The Lord has permitted a deceiving spirit to convince these 400 prophets to motivate Ahab to fight against Aram. King Ahab was surrounded by a bunch of yes men who told the king everything that he wanted to hear. And in this case, their counsel was no different. It is apparent that God gave Ahab over to a reprobate man. The disaster that faces Ahab rests solely on the recommendation of this group of prophets. Micaiah told Ahab the truth, but he rejected Micaiah's advice. And because he refused to listen to this man's advice, it would prove to be costly in the end. Hard-headed. Let me give you some added info. So, when Micaiah started prophesying these things, look at here. Now, here come another prophet getting in the face of Micaiah. Now, Zedekiah, son of Chenana, and one of the heathen prophets, he walked over because he was offended by this man saying that the Lord had put a lie in all of their mouths. So Zedekiah, he going to step up to the plate, and he going to step to Micaiah. And he walked over, and he slapped this man in the face. When did the Spirit of the Lord leave me and speak to you? And Micaiah replied and said, you will have the answer to your question when you find yourself hiding in a room. Now we're going to move on to 26 through 28. And the king of Israel said, take Micaiah and carry him back unto Ammon, the governor of the city, and to Joash, the king's son, and say, thus saith the king, put this fellow in the prison and feed him with bread of affliction and with water of affliction until I come in peace. And Micaiah said, if thou return at all in peace, the Lord had not spoken by me. And he said, hearken, O people, every one of you. King Ahab was so furious, y'all. And he had heard enough of the truth that was, he didn't want to hear these things. He had heard enough. He said, take him to Ammon, the mayor of the city, and to my son, Joash. Micaiah's arrest was tragic because the original prophecy was in the best interest of both nations. But when a nation is led by a greedy and evil ruler, it is a real possibility that both nations will suffer tragedy. It's the truth. He then gave out further instructions on how he wanted Micaiah to be treated while he was in prison. Feed him nothing but bread and water. And only enough to keep him alive. Don't even give him a whole piece of bread. Don't even give him a whole glass of water. But just keep him, give him enough to keep him barely alive until I come back and return in peace. Now to show you how bold and defiant Micaiah was after he heard this, he replied back and said, if you return in peace, and then he backed it up. If you return in peace, it will prove that the Lord has not spoken to me. And he hasn't spoken through me. Then he turned to all those people that were standing nearby and said, y'all better take note of what I just said. And in summary, let me say this. How many times have you heard that people don't like hearing the truth? It is because they want someone to rubber stamp their wrongdoings. And this is what the case was with King Ahab. He had a love-hate relationship with prophecy, and he only asked for it when he needed it. But because of his refusal to accept the truth, he ended up losing his life. If you read further on in the scripture, he dies in battle, just the way this man prophesied. He ended up losing his life because he relied upon the encouraging words of his lying prophets. Let me leave you with this before we end this lesson. A real sign of a true friend is someone to tell you what you need to hear and not always what you want to hear. And that is your church school lesson for May the 2nd, 2021. And if there is anyone out there that does not know Jesus in the pardon of their sin, I encourage you today to get to know Jesus Christ. Repent of your sins and get baptized in a Bible-believing, Bible-teaching church. And once you've done all of that, call on the Lord and ask him what is his plan for your life, because he has a plan for you. He will reveal it to you, but you got to go to him in all sincerity. Lord, what is it that you want me to do? What can I do for you today? And once you've done that, it will blow your mind what God will do through you. And until we meet again, my brothers and sisters, no matter what you're going through, no matter what your problems are, no matter the situation, I am a living witness. You can always, always, always trust in the Lord. God bless you.